topic of the shiur is, what is my life's mission? Before we begin, a tremendous yasher koyach to the initiator of this shiur and sponsor, Dr. Daniel Weil and his family. Shem should give them all the benefits of the Torah and a gathering like this. There's a medrash that says that one of the rabbis, Rabbi Yoshua ben Hananya, who was called the Chakima de Yehudoin, the wisest of the rabbis, when he came to the site of the Beis HaMikdash and he saw it in its state of destruction, he said, woe is to us that this place that was able to forgive and atone for all of our mistakes, all of our sins, and it's not available, it's not existent. And his rabbi, Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai, said to him, Bini, my son, al yeralach, don't feel bad. Yesh lanu kapora achas shehi kemoisa. There is a substitute for all the sacrifices, everything that took place in the Beis HaMikdash. Ve'ezel, what is it? Zegmilas chasodim. When Jews show consideration for each other, that's bringing sacrifices in the Beis HaMikdash, to the extent where the prophet Hosea says, he quoting Hashem, Ki chesed chofatzti v'loy zevach. Hashem says, I want kindness, not sacrifices. That's an incredible statement to make it emphatically clear how significant this is, how much Hashem wants us to emulate him. And here we're told there's the famous pasuk in the Chumash, which tells us that a Jew's mission in the world is ledofka voy, to attach ourselves deeply to Hashem, dveikus. And Rashi says, what do you mean? How do you attach yourself to infinite? How do you attach yourself to something spiritual, something that's not tangible? The answer is, hidofku bimidoisov, by emulating his character traits. This week, tonight is Thursday night. This Shabbos, we're going to be reading Parshas Vayera. And again, if we look, we can find this on every page, in every line in the Torah. I'm mentioning this because this is current events. The Torah begins that there was a Jew, Avram Avinu, 99 years old. Hashem instructed him to go through an operation, a bris milah, a circumcision. Avram Avinu was loyal and faithful to Hashem. Yes, sir. And he went ahead and performed this bris milah. His sandak was Hashem himself. And Avram Avinu had this circumcision. And as the Torah tells us, after an operation generally, the third day after the operation is when a person feels the pain the most. And the Torah tells us, Vayero Elov Hashem be'eloine mamre. Hashem came to and revealed himself to Avram Avinu in order to teach us. Hashem is revealing himself. He's revealing how he conducts himself and how we want to conduct ourselves. Someone is ill, I go visit that person. I take my time. My time means my life. Time is not money, time is life. I'm taking part of my life and giving it away to another human being, to another person. That's what Hashem considers significant, important. If you look there, the commentaries point out, if you look there, you don't see Hashem speaking to Avram Avinu. There's no mention of what Hashem said to him. It says he revealed to him, and it was the heat of the day, and suddenly three angels show up, a whole story. One second. Who cares that he revealed it? Who cares that he came to see? What did he say? He didn't. He came to see him. Just like the law says in Shulchan Aruch, when someone is ill, you go visit that person, and it's not a matter of what you're going to say. Look around, see what do they need. Do they need a glass of water? Do they need a cover? Do they need something to be concerned about? Not about me. It's not about what I'm going to say. It's about what that person needs and what that person needs to hear. And the Chofetz Chaim says that this applies to every aspect of life. Rabbi Nachman writes that he wrote this 200 years ago, that in our times, you're walking in the street and someone is coming towards you, an old friend or an old acquaintance or a relative. You don't know that that person has come to a conclusion in their mind and their heart that they'd like to die. They would really like to drop dead. Why? Why not? Life is so complicated and difficult. It's a struggle. Every second is a struggle. Health is a struggle. Watching your weight is a struggle. Shalom bayis is a struggle. Raising children is... Who needs it? It's so much. It seems so much more convenient to stay in bed and die. And if I died, who would care? Who would notice? Who would, nobody cares. Nobody knows. And you're walking towards that person and you say, hi, I can't believe it. I haven't seen you in such a long time. Where have you been? I'm so happy to see, wow, you just made my day. And you could actually literally be saving. There are stories of people who were saved from committing suicide physically by something like that, a good word, a smile, making that person feel that they count, they are a somebody. These are the midos. These are just a tiny sampling of the character traits that Hashem reveals to us about himself, how Hashem works, how he operates. And the more that we study and understand the character traits of Hashem and try to emulate them on our level in this world of darkness, we're turning on a bulb and another bulb, and then the moon and the sun will become one. We started again that the sun is the essence of Hashem. It corresponds to Hashem's name, Yud Kei Vav Kei, which defines the Atzmius of Hashem. Elokim, or Aleph Dalet Nun Yud, represent how Hashem is viewed in this world. The moon, the lower level. We're told that when Moshiach comes, the light of the moon and the sun are going to come together. Hashem Hu Elokim. They're going to become, then it's going to be real oneness. Then we'll see, we'll enjoy the full light. B'mheira v'yameinu, amen v'yameinu.